the junction. I'm sure in the prior history was correct, for the PCS. PCS nickel is a junction one to which the fat, amino acids, carbohydrate, metabolism, they pass through the. The PCS cycle is completely hampered in the patients having obstructive sleep. As a result, what happens? It becomes metabolism, nucleic acid metabolism, endogenous inhibitors, especially tyrosine metabolism, are also altered significantly. Well, what happens? We have seen the amino acid metabolism is hampered. The fat metabolism is hampered and the result will be how does the epoxide is cast? You can see that one here. This implemented epoxide is due to the cell block. The cells are completely loaded with the fatty acids, amino acids, which are not useful for the body. As a result, what happens? That the intracellular system activation, tissue lipolysis, release fatty acids, cells are impaired with fatty acids, non-nucleated of fatty acids, impaired insulin sensitivity to this other activities. So this is the result of hypoxia and acid. So virtually, I told you the reasons of schizophrenia, I told you how the metabolism happens, how it causes hypoxia and also causes this slide is showing the patient's skin was say metabolized and diabetes. On the left panel you can see circadian management. This causes hypothyroid and this circadian management back mismanagement presents in the patients in the workers who are working in the night. And the students who are studying in the night, burning in the night hour, not having sleep, not having sleep for sleep. They will also have this problem. They will have decreased glucose tolerance, hormonal changes, sympathetic nervous system driving to death, and then it increases the catabolics and result the glucose tolerance is hampered. This causes glucose dysregulation and it increases the insulin resistance. On the right side, you can see sleep loss causes an hypoxic depression. Now, when you are sleepless, you feel more hungry, isn't it? When you are sleepless, you tend to crave because of two hormones, ghrelin and leptin. And when the eating habits report, hormonal changes causes obesity. That in turn again causes the glucose dissociation. Or you don't have a point of opportunity. Per se, the obstructive schizophrenia causes hypoxia. Number of times the patient wakes up. You will not be having sound sleep. You will not be having sound sleep. By the time NREM phase is over, it's going to REM phase, it changes. Because the glottis is closed. The glottis is closed and you will have the snoring. It changes left, right changes. So this is known as sleep fragmentation. You will not enjoy the sleep. You will not have the REM phase. You will not have the dreams. And then in the morning you will feel more fatty here. Now as a result of this thing, the further derangement of the metabolism will be there. And there are two hormones which are very important, leptin and ghrelin. The leptin is situated in the hypothalamus and the parathalamus. Ghrelin is situated in the gastric stomach. Ghrelin increases the brain, leptin decreases the brain. Especially during the NREM days, there are so many we sleep, we don't have appetite because leptin is more active. Right? Sometimes this is causes. There will be ghrelin will be more and the patient tends to keep up. What is more? What about the leptin? This is the latest one. The leptin levels are different sleep duration, relationship with hypothyroid imbalance, connection with cannabis. Carbohydrate regulation, thyrotropin, and cortisol. So this leptin once again, the six reasons why I have shown you by the hexagon. All the six are indirectly responsible to control the leptin, especially steroids. You know the steroids, they are the stress hormones. They are very, very important. Especially the steroids
will have diagonal variation. The leptin is more, steroid will be more. Leptin is less, steroid is less. So this is how the leptin hormone is very much important in sleep regulation. Sleep duration is an excellent study. Any sleep less than 7 hours is not useful. Any sleep more than 9 hours also is useless. To my dear students, I have been elaborating here because I am sticking to the unrelated control of the thing. The question is, especially during the worst disease, if you are sleeping less than 7 hours, your memory will be very poor.